I'm very pleased that Judge Brennan held the defendant without bail on two theories, that he was a flight risk and also that he's a danger to the community. The governor has filed legislation on dangerousness that the legislature may take up in the fall. It's been a very important issue to me because with respect to the dangerousness statute, you are limited in district court and superior court to prosecute a case within 6 months in superior court or 120 days. I've advocated that clearly that's not enough time, that in this particular case, the evidence, you know, there'll be a lot of evidence, complicated, that should be changed to what reflects the current rule of a speedy trial to 1 year. It's critical that someone such as this defendant be held without bail during the pendency of his case. In addition to flight risk, that means someone is a risk to, a real risk not to appear in court. Here's an individual who took off to Maine for reasons of potentially being implicated in these crimes, been up there for whatever it's been, 17 years, and clearly he should not be entitled to bail based on the facts. So I think it's critical in legislation and or existing case law that judges know, because there's confusion about it, they can hold someone without bail as a flight risk. Clearly Judge Brennan found today that you can, others seem to be inconclusive. But if someone's not going to appear in court, I'm not interested in cash bail being set. I'm interested in them being held because they're a legitimate flight risk to the end of their case, absent a significant change in circumstances. So again, I'm very pleased that the defendant has been brought before the court to answer these most serious charges. The case will proceed through the criminal justice system, and it also highlights the importance of bail reform with respect to eliminating unreasonable time limits on prosecuting defendants who are held as dangers, and that's something I will continue to advocate for.
What does it mean to your office, investigators in your office, and the victims' families to see this defendant ordered held without bail?
Well, I am elated, frankly, that this defendant has been apprehended, and we're in the first official step of bringing him to justice. He's entitled to the protections as any citizen, but I can only imagine, you know, thinking back over 20 plus years to the victims in this case who were just going about their ordinary lives, doing ordinary things that we all do, and who were treated so inhumanely and brutally. I hope, despite what terrible things alleged to have happened to them, that they can have, you know, have some solace that we put the effort in to get this guy. We've got him here, and he's going to have to answer for these crimes. And we're going to do everything in our power to make sure he never gets out of jail again.
Thank you.
Thank you.